Welcome. In this video, I'll be solving this mixed integer problem in Excel. X1, X2, and X3 are integers, and Y1, Y2, and Y3 are 0, 1 or binary variables. I'm going to set up my variables at the top here, and next to them, I will place the objective function value. I'm going to place the solution to the problem on the second row here. I will highlight these cells yellow. That would be the values of the decision variables at optimal solution. And for the objective function, I will use green. I will place the objective function coefficients in the third row here. For constraint 1, the coefficients are 1, 1, and 1 for x1, x2, and x3 respectively. I'm going to click on constraint 1 and drag down the handle up to constraint 4. For constraint 2, we have 1 for x1 and negative 400 for y1. For constraint 3, they are 1 for x2 and negative 550 for y2. For constraint 4, we have 1 for x3 and negative 600 for y3. Now I'm going to highlight these cells that will contain the constraint formulas and fill them with light blue. For visual purposes, I'm going to place the constraint signs and the right-hand sides here. Apostrophe and equal to display the equality sign for the first constraint. Then insert symbol to select the less than or equal sign for the second. Then drag down since the last two have the same sign. I'm going to place the constraint right hand sides here. I'm going to place the objective function formula in this green cell by using equal sum product. Highlight the coefficients, comma, then the variable values in yellow here. That multiplies each coefficient with the adjacent variable and adds the products. Then enter. We do the same for the constraints. Equals sum product, select the constraint coefficients, comma, then the variable cells. But this time, I'm going to press the F4 button after selecting the yellow cells to make them absolute cells, so I can drag to fill the other cells with the formula while keeping the yellow cells locked down. Double-clicking the formula for the last constraint here shows that it worked. Now I'm going to click Data, then Solver to solve the problem. If you don't see Solver here, please see description on how to add it. For Set Objective, we will click the green cell that contains the objective function formula here. Since this is a minimization problem, we will select mean here. The changing cells will be the yellow cells that will contain the variable values at optimal solution. Next, click Add to add the constraints. Click on the formula for the first constraint, select the equal sign, then click on the right-hand side. Click Add. Since the remaining constraints all have less than or equal signs, highlight them all at once. Select the less than or equal sign and then the right-hand sides. Click Add. Since the x's are integers, highlight their values here and select int for integer. Click Add. The y's are 0, 1 variables. So select them and choose binary. Click OK since we've finished adding constraints. Now make sure this non-negative box is checked to enforce non-negativity. Then select Simplex LP here since we're doing linear programming. Click Solve. We can already see the solution and the objective function value here, but we can also generate an answer report if we want. And we can view the answer report here. And that's it. Thanks for watching.